Will you be mine, baby?
You're a cheap date. Welcome to the vlog, week 18. We got a big day ahead of us. We got a game here this afternoon.
Wait. You got a game today? Is that what you just said?
Yeah, it's a little abnormal. It's the first time we've done it. Maybe the last time, who knows? We'll see what happens tonight. If we win, it might be a new thing.
You know, I'd like to try my hand at cooking, maybe make a home-cooked meal. Let me redo that.
Chris said that.
Did he?
This Monday, a jewelry company, Majuri, reached out to us asking us to make a video for them. They said it'd be coming on Thursday, so we made the order. It did not come on Thursday. It got lost in the mail. We had to go track it down, find it. It finally showed up today. Inconveniently, it's game day today, and that's why we are here making a TikTok right now on game day. Let's go ask some of the guys what they think about filming TikToks on game day.
I don't love it, but it is what it is, and it's, I mean, more time with the guys, so it's pretty fun.
Oh, it's pretty fun, actually. We came here with a plan, we executed it, and we're getting better, right? We're more organized.
Yeah. So what we are doing, we are telling everybody our ideal Valentine's Day date.
So if I had a Valentine, what I would do would want to spend the day with her, go for lunch, exchange gifts, probably go for supper, and then do an activity that we both enjoy.
My ideal date would be someplace warm, maybe have a picnic, and then end it off with like a little carriage ride or something.
How about you?
I want to go for a walk, see a sunset, go maybe see a movie, get supper, and a lot of smooching. And a sailboat ride in the dead of winter.
Probably do some sort of cute Hallmark date, like ice skating or something fake that we never do, but.
We're coming to you live from the shack. We're gonna do a little cook-off here. See who makes a better meal. We always debate.
Yeah. We're gonna taste test at the end and let you know who wins.
In the greens out.
After that, fire up the grill, season the steak,
and let it burn.
No, don't let it burn.
You don't like veggies?
I've been changing my ways.
You're doing a lot of standing around and not a lot of cooking. What's going on?
Well, I'm mainly waiting for my little potato.
Let's go check out on little Spud. Hi, little Spud. How you doing in there?
Yeah, I dug it up with these bare hands.
Wow. Little Spud with big cud. Gonna have a meal tonight.
Little Spud with big cud. You like that one.
Check on the steak fries. One of my favorite sides of all time.
Bing, fries right down. Will's stuff is on. He's got his steak and green beans on there.
It's a very chilly night out here, as you can see my breath.
What's cooking good looking?
Some steak.
It's about to get coconutty.
First, you coat the shrimp. It goes into the wash.
Can you explain to the people what the wash is?
It's a southern word for wash. And then you add some coconut. Just like that.
Because why?
It's about to get coconutty.
This is how I toss my salad.
No, this is exactly what happens when Will's in the kitchen.
I got cream, tomatoes, check, you name it.
That's not where a steak goes, Cuddy.
Yeah, I want to take some to find out.
How's it going today, so far, boys? Happy with things
great.
So far?
Yeah, I'm waiting for Will to get his dang overburnt, well-done steak off the grill so I can cook mine.
He likes to chomp on it for hours. That's why he's got an unreal jawline.
Oh. Just how I like it. This might be a $45 steak.
Oh my, okay. Where's my $6 steak? I can't find my steak.
Does anybody on the YouTube know where my steak is?
It's on the grill.
This is what I had it on.
The yard cat must have got it. How do you lose a steak?
All right, this ain't funny, I'm hungry. Oh my. Oh, yeah. Cooking it over the fire.
Well, that looks well done. All right, I'm gonna check out Will's final product here.
All right, Cuddy.
I'd give that probably an 8.
Nice.
8 out of 10.
Final product of Colton Glenn Bates. Looks pretty good.
Takes the tooth out.
First bite.
Nice, nutritious.
Milk, OJ, unite.
So as you can see, we do not care to eat with Cuddy. There's a lot of reasons for that. He doesn't chew with his mouth closed ever.
I will have to give your rating. It does look very good. Don't see many greens on there, if any at all. I'm gonna have to give you an 8.1.
Oh, come on. One bite, everybody knows the rules.
Whoa, caveman, dang.
You guys starting to see why me and Will don't eat with him?
No, let's try a piece of shrimp.
Oh yeah, stuff it in there, buddy.
Oh!
Oh! Get a bite of little Spud. Yeah!
Oh, wash it down.
Wash it down, greasy fingers.
Oh yeah. That's how you eat like a farmer.
Reporting live from the ice arena, the boys met up with the news team today. I didn't get the call to interview them, but I'm sure it's great.
So we are Fox 21. We're at the Marriott right now, and we're here to interview the guys.
I cleaned my room. It looks actually very nice.
What does it look like? Right now. I was born ready.
Are you getting interviewed today? No,
I'm not. Not today.
Why not?
I got cut But I made my room clean, so in case Dave stumbles over there, I'm next in line. We'll see how big this stack gets. Just collecting them. I think it's pretty cool to see like what people got to say. My favorite fan mail that I wake up to every single morning. Here it is. Isn't that a stud?
Oh,
Mort, buddy.
I'm Red Mike. She's Blue Mike.
Who's Mike?
It's been quite an experience, and it's been very exciting. I got my head out the sunroof. I'm blasting my favorite tunes. I only got one thing on my mind. You got me stuck on the thought of you. You're making me feel brand new. You're more than a sunshine in my eyes. You know what? I was up late last night thinking about how I'm missing something in my life, and that something ended up to be a puppy. So we're here. I'm gonna pick out a dog, and I'm gonna adopt it. Fun. I don't like this. Cuddy's being a big baby right now. He's scared of the barking. Cuddy's about to lose his other arm here.
Yeah, I want this guy.
Toasted coconut.
They said 20 of them came from the same house, and now they're all like hiding and scared.
What are the keys to dog whispering?
Like a soft whine.
Not working.
We actually made
my
adopt.
Hand.
They all grow up sadly, eh, Dave?
I know.
I won't ever get a cat. I don't think.
You're gonna have 20 cats when you're older. Your house is gonna smell like cat piss. As you can tell, I'm a cat holder.
Lorax ran away.
Get him! Get him! Oh!
We got him.
What are your cats doing?
They're meeting for the first time.
They're making out.
The game plan is we're fostering. There's a husky back there named Toasted Coconut, and I think the Marriott might be fostering him.
We should do all 20 chihuahuas.
Are you sure you can do this with one arm, Cuddy?
I don't know.
He's not going to make the cut for the video,
no.
I think.
This guy might.
All right, here's audition number one. Dude, aren't you supposed to be in the video, man? Have you guys bonded pretty good or no?
He doesn't like me. I don't really like him all that much. I think it's more me.
You got the dog hammock going. Gum, gum, gum. Bah.
Living the vida loca.
Hold on. Hold on.
Dog treats.
That is not good.
Take three, let's go. We've been at this video for about 10 to 20 minutes already. It's getting pretty annoying today. I tell them to come prepared. They're not performing well. I kind of think we're just gonna go home now. Didn't get it done.
You were pretty happy we didn't bring home Toasted Coconut, hey, Ollie?
Yeah, I've seen Toasted Coconut before, like on the street. I'm as happy that you didn't bring him home. Thanks, Dad.
Oh,
I love
good
you.
Boy.
Yeah. Hey, we're coming at you with the easiest party pleaser around. Bruschetta on this episode of Saucin' with Austin. Okay, first things first, we gotta slice the tomatoes.
Oh my gosh.
Sorry about the lighting in here. We're gonna have to upgrade it for next episode.
Looks like we got a couple guests that are looking for an extra bite to eat.
Now we're just chopping up our basil and we're gonna hit it with the salt. Always gotta do a quality control first.
Oh my god, nice. I'm nailing these things today. You know, last week we got some pretty mediocre scores, so I stepped my game up a little bit. And lastly, some olive oil. Dude, mix that in. Touch of garlic powder before you mix. One more secret ingredient. We're adding a little heat to this one with some cayenne. You know, for bread, I'm going with a sourdough. Just crisps up super nice and has a great little extra flavor to it. Lastly, we're hitting the bread with a bit of olive oil to give it that prime crispiness that we need.
Hey, quiet on set!
Sorry, Austin.
Okay, now that the bread's in the oven being toasted, you're gonna hit it with a little bit of balsamic.
Balsamic or balsamic?
Balsamic.
We're gonna have to ask the Italian the proper way to say this word. Balsamic? Balsamic.
Balsamic.
Frizz is balsamic.
Oh, frizz is made out of ceramic, so yeah, that makes sense.
I had a little misstep. I forgot I wasn't making regular bruschetta. I'm making a roasted red pepper bruschetta, so I'm gonna quickly chop those up. I know.
Darn it.
Can't believe I messed that up.
And I'll clean up after him.
Yeah, you did.
I got the dishwasher going.
Bread is toasted. Now I'm gonna need a little tip. I heard that you're supposed to rub the bread with garlic, but I don't know if you do it before or after it's toasted, so leave a comment if you actually know what you're supposed to do. Shannon, big shout out to you. Custom made this cutting board. I appreciate it. We're gonna be putting the bruschetta on this and getting ready to plate. Time to get artsy with the balsamic glaze. Balsamic glaze.
I'll tell you one thing, he's saucing that glaze on pretty good right now.
No free smells on this one, eh?
Bread's toasted. We're the No Bad Days podcast, and we're going to be reviewing Saucin' with Austin.
A little bruschetta.
See how it goes.
Would you guys say that hits different or no?
It's good. It is really good. It is good. I'm going to give it a 7.6. It's generous because, you know what, he works hard at it. I know he enjoys it. It's made with love. It's just missing
Look
something.
How happy he is.
Missing something.
I don't know what it's missing. I thought I'm going to go with a 6.8. It's pretty good. I'm a repeat offender on the bruschetta. He made this for me this summer, so pretty damn good.
No, I'm going to give him a 7.8. And the only reason it's not in the high eights is because I think with more time and to let the ingredients kind of ferment in that bowl, that would have made it better. But overall, really good job.
I'd agree. I like that. Let the ingredients sing, dance, have fun together. Really elevates it. My Saucin' rating, I think that'll be mid to high 7.7. That was episode 3 of Saucin' with Austin. The recipe's in the description. We'll see you next week.
All right, thanks for watching episode 18. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next Thursday.
After this past year, I'll tell you one thing right now, that Frizz is getting pretty damn good on camera. Because 8 takes, 10 takes, he's like 1 or 2 now, so.
Oh no, the camera.
This will give me the perfect amount of energy for me to play fast and strong tonight.
Fast and strong.
Holy cow.
That's the end of the vlog.